In accordance with the open meeting law, the board states for the record that this meeting is being recorded by NORCAM and may be recorded by other local media. Please rise for the pledge.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
I'd like to welcome our guests this evening and those watching on cable. First order of business is to sign the October town meeting warrant.
Mr. Chairman, I move to sign the October 2016 town meeting warrant.
Second.
Second by Mr. O'Leary. Any discussion? Hearing none. All. Mr. Gilberto.
Just a note that, again, this will be the warrant that will be posted upon this board's vote and the signature of the board. So any adjustments we would need to make to the warrant would need to be made now rather than later on, because he's going to walk out with a signed copy of it. So we just remind everyone of that.
I'll ask the members if there's any changes to the warrant that is in our packet.
Okay, wouldn't we go through the warrant articles tonight and then just do it at the end? Wouldn't that be the most logical thing?
It would be.
I'm sorry?
Wouldn't we want to go through all the articles?
It's not what we've done in the past.
And then sign it at the end?
Traditionally, the board is signed at the beginning because the constable's been present to witness it being signed.
All right. I've always been curious why we do it this way.
I think we're all set on the articles.
The one thing, Mr. Chairman, through that I would note is that at the last meeting, the Community Planning Commission stated that it was going to be removing one article relative to zoning that addressed the J.T. Berry property in particular, along with other similarly zoned properties. There was a second related article that they've also withdrawn, and the version of the article that's in front of you this evening is the correct version without those two articles.
And then an article that wasn't in is now in, right? There's still two left.
Correct. There's one zoning article that's left, and there is one funding article.
Funding article.
Yeah.
That was not in last week.
It wasn't last week.
Yep.
It's not new. It just is not being removed.
The only difference is that one article that was still included last week has now been removed at their request.
Correct.
So the current version of the warrant that we have in front of us has that removed.
So with that, are there any changes board members want to make before we sign the warrant?
Mr. Chairman, to be clear, that leaves two zoning articles that are left, one funding and two zoning articles. There were four zoning articles last meeting. They withdrew one at the meeting and subsequently removed the second.
Okay. So my question is, what's in our meeting packet tonight matches what we're going to vote on right now and sign?
Yes, that's correct.
Okay.
Okay.
Oh, there's a question.
Mr. Keller has a question.
Could I ask the people at the table up here to speak into the microphones? We can't hear you now.
Okay.
Does this work?
Testing.
Can you hear me now?
It does. It does work.
Okay.
Okay.
Sorry.
Well.
Yes.
Do we have a chance to take a look at them? I mean, there's only 12, right? That way we can, I mean, that's what Selectman Prisco's suggesting, right?
There's
13.
There's 13.
That's correct.
If that's the wishes of the board, that's what we'll do.
Shouldn't take us that long.
We're going through them anyway.
Okay.
We're going through them anyway, so, right?
All right.
Mr. Chairman, through you, would it be helpful if we were to go through the PowerPoint presentation at this point in time rather than go through them individually and then go through them individually again?
Yes.
We have a presentation that I know the finance director is updated. Thank you, Liz, for your efforts.
And to save time, we'll assign them as we go through.
That's great.
That work for everybody?
Yes.
Okay.
Killing a lot of birds with one stone.
Yes.
Okay.
Mr. Chairman, through you, Article Number One, the standard here and act on the reports of town officers and committees requires both an assignment and a recommendation.
Mr. Chairman, I move to recommend Article One, here and act on reports of town officers and committees.
Second.
Second by Mr. O'Leary.
Sure.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Unanimous? Mr. O'Leary, want to start the meeting off?
Oh, with pleasure. That's a winner.
I wanted that one.
You wanted that one? Actually, yeah, I'll defer to someone else, Mr. Chairman, on the opening.
All right, Jeffrey?
I'll do that.
Jeff?
Yes, I'll do that, yeah.
Article Two, prior year's bills.
Mr. Chairman, this would be an article for payment of prior year bills. Excuse me while I update that. The transfer is proposing the amount of $2,390.95. I would ask the finance director just to speak to the particular articles.
Sure. So it's come to our attention. There was two bills that were found for 2012, 2014 for boiler inspections. So those bills are in the amounts that they total $500 for the two of the bills. We have some Reading transcript, North Reading transcript bills as well. And we also have some aggregate industry bills. So the North Reading transcript is $1,004.50. As I said, the boiler inspections total $500 and aggregate industries total $886.45 for a total of $2,390.95, which will be funded by free cash. We do not have a free cash certification number at this time.
Mr. Chairman, through you, we do expect, and we've received a reasonable level of assurance from the Department of Revenue that we will have free cash certified in time for the October town meeting.
Yes.
Do we have an estimate? I'm sorry, Mr. Chairman. Do we have an estimate on the free cash yet? Just an estimate?
It will be more than last year. And last year was almost $1.7 million.
Ms. Manfilly.
Is that bill for the transcript for legal ads?
No. There's several. There's some employment ads, the special collection day for DPW.
So it's advertisements? Mr. Chairman, I move to recommend Article 2, prior year's bills.
Second.
Second by Mr. Yule?
Yeah, second.
Oh, Mr. O'Leary? No, Mr. Yule.
Yeah.
All in favor?
Aye. Aye.
Opposed? Unanimous? Jeff, why don't you do that one too, and then we'll shift.
Mr. Chairman, through you, prior to going through the rest of the funding articles, I would just note the notation of available funds that we have. Again, the finance director just spoke to free cash. Balance of stabilization is just over $2 million. Debt capital stabilization, $984,000. The cell tower fund, $383,000. The ambulance fund, $559,000. The OPEB trust, $554,000. And the water infrastructure stabilization fund at $448,000. Again, we await the certification of retained earnings for the water enterprise as we do for free cash as well.
Okay.
And there's a screenshot here that we've proposed for the funding alternatives relative to the particular articles, and I could speak to them as we go through individually for those that we have the numbers for. So we've done Article 2. Moving to Article 3, this would be a transfer of funds to the Capital Improvement Stabilization Fund. Again, the balance, $984,000. The article would propose to add $200,000 from free cash.
If I may, Mr. Chairman, the $200,000 that is proposed for this article is part of the capital plan. Depending on the amount of free cash certification, we could add additional funds. But this is what the capital plan calls for this year.
May I have a motion?
Mr. Chairman, I move to recommend a town meeting Article 3, transfer funds to Capital Improvement Stabilization Fund.
Second.
Second by Mr. Yule. Mr. Prisco.
I would appreciate, though, as we do this every year, I know when we, in June, when we go through the capital as well, you give us an update, but I would like to continue to see a report of what's been funded from our capital, what we've approved, what we went to town meeting before and funded. I know we're putting more money in here, and I understand the reason for it, but I still would like to continue to get some routine updates on our process of spending funding, our capital funding. We approve these projects, and we just never see them getting done, or I never hear any information about them getting done or updated. So I don't know if there's an ongoing report that the capital stabilization, I mean the capital CIP group puts together, but I would appreciate getting a copy of it.
So just for clarification purposes, you would like a status report of where the approved capital stands, whether it's in progress, completed, not yet started? Okay.
Right. I know we're not asking for any in October, but as we're asking to put more money in to a stabilization, I would still like to get an update on how we're doing, how we're tracking to what we're approving. Because we do have some things that we approved 2 years ago that still haven't even got started. For example, I still haven't heard anything on the water meters, the new water meters that we purchased or we were supposed to purchase, and heck, I'm not even sure those quotes will be any good anymore. So it kind of worries me as we continue to put more money into this, are we even keeping track of what we've already approved? I have a big concern.
We are, and I'm not sure if we reported that at our first meeting, we did not review it
at our next meeting.
Which is October 12th?
We had a reorganization meeting, but that's about all we did.
Okay, thank you for the update.
This money, by the way, Michael, is going in there for next year's capital plan.
I know. And I don't want to invest any more money in capital if we're not spending the money on the capital we've already approved at previous town meetings. That's why I want to know.
Okay.
Mrs. Minipelli has a question, Mr. Mayor.
Yes.
There was a report, I think it was around the budget deliberations or the budget presentations, and I think it was from your office, Liz, that tracked that for us, what year, what project, whether it was completed. And I thought that was really helpful. It's a fairly long list, but even just updating that and adding what was newly approved would be great.
Yes. So I would assume that that presentation could be made to the board after it's given to the Capital Improvement Planning Committee. So on October 12th, we are reviewing that, and then you know, after the town meeting, your next Board of Selectmen's meeting, we could, you know, discuss that, review that.
Yeah, that would be great, because we have a strategic planning session, I think, coming around then, too, so I think that'll actually help us.
I can provide the information after October 12th, and then we can review it publicly if necessary.
Thank you. Good suggestion.
So maybe for purposes of town meeting, we could use the one that was presented during budget so that if there is an inquiry about it, that, you know, the parties that are in attendance can see that.
There will be an updated list by town meeting.
That's great.
Either, you know, we can use the June one or we can use the current one.
Yeah, that's great.
Thank you.
Motion, please.
It's already been seconded, Mr. Chairman. Yeah.
Oh, okay. So on the motion, all in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Opposed? And Mr. O'Leary, will you take that? You're a member of the Capital Planning Committee. Article 4, appropriate money to stabilization fund. And the sponsor is Finance Committee.
So this is a townwide rainy day fund, the balance at over $2 million. The article proposes here to add $200,000, and the funding source would be free cash.
Mr. Chairman, if I may add, it has been quite a few years since we have appropriated funds to the stabilization fund, and I think that this, you know, is a good idea that we do that this year. We still have not met the 5% of net revenues as of this time. So I think that this year is a good year to deposit funds into this fund.
So I guess the problem I have with it is not the concept of putting money in. And I believe we should be putting some money in. I'm not 100% convinced it should be $200,000. And I only say that because if I knew what the free cash number, the absolute free cash number was, I may not be questioning it.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Well, so, I mean,
you're a member of the financial planning team. You kind of know where we are going into the next fiscal year. And that's why I raise the question.
I feel comfortable with $200,000. You know, without free cash being certified, I am hesitant to give you a figure, but I will tell you that we ended the year in a better position than we did last year. So it will be more than $1.7 million.
Michael.
What is the number of the 5% of net revenues?
I can get that figure for you.
Well, we're waiting for that. Any other questions?
Mr. Kelleher is saying that we're close to $5 million short.
$5 million short, okay.
I think that's right. I'm not
approximate.
So with the sizable number that you project for free cash, would you even consider increasing this number more? No. No? Okay.
Okay. We have a motion on Article 4.
Mr. Chairman, I move to recommend a town meeting Article 4, appropriate money to stabilization fund.
Second.
Second by Mr. Yule. Further discussion? Hearing none. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Michael, you want to take that?
Sure. Yeah. And Steve's only up there with one, so.
That's all right. He's got a couple coming.
Good. Well, do you want me to take number three as well? Oh, no, that's right, because he's on that committee. Never mind. You don't mind getting up. You could use the exercise, I think.
You could have it. You want it?
Oh, you could probably use the exercise, right?
Well, going up if that's the standard, I better do all of these items.
You want me to take three then?
Sure.
Okay.
Yep.
Article 5, transfer funds to other post-employment benefits liability trust fund. That's the OPEB. We've been putting in at the June town meeting. We brought it up to
$250,000, although as we identified, I believe, in July during the actuary's presentation, we're going to review that number in light of the actuarial update that took place this summer, we anticipate that we'll need to adjust that number for the FY17 planning process based on what the actuary reports. We hope to have that in the middle part of the fall.
So you don't have a number yet?
We're not recommending a transfer in at this point in time.
Oh, okay.
We recommend any adjustment take place at the June town meeting.
Okay, we have a motion and a recommendation from the town administrator to pass over Article 5. Further discussion?
Oh.
My only question is, we've made a commitment to put some money in there. Are we anticipating that, I mean, we're already behind the eight ball on it, are we anticipating that this actuarial study and the numbers that evolve from it would anticipate to be less than what we would normally be doing or what we committed to doing, which was adding $50,000 a year?
I guess it's going to be more. Right?
Well, I guess it's going to be more, but the availability of funds even in June may be less than what we have available now. And for planning purposes, why wouldn't we just put in what was scheduled to be put in, and if we want to adjust it in June and we have the wherewithal to do it, then
just
do
to
it.
Stand corrected, Steve, we've been putting in the amount in the June budget for 2000 for the current year, right? So
we're putting in a dollar amount and then whatever the new employees were going to be costing us, I thought, or something.
Well, you need an actuarial to get to that number, so whether we do it every year or every other year to keep up, right? The board's committed to put that amount of money in to cover so that essentially new employees
fall
off of our
commitment. Right, we finally stopped the bleeding, right.
Yeah.
So, Liz had her hand raised.
Yes, sorry.
I was only going to add that it is part of our operating plan annually now, so we do not fund it from free cash. This would be if we needed to increase the amount that we plan on having as part of our operating budget, and we are awaiting that figure from the actuary of how much the per new employee cost is with the new valuation.
Will we have that information before town meeting?
Yes.
Between October town meeting?
Yes.
Yes. So why don't we just...
We're passing it over then.
Yeah, right.
Vote to make a recommendation at town meeting.
Mr. Chairman, I move to make a recommendation at town meeting regarding Article 5, transfer of funds to other post-employment benefits liability trust fund.
Second.
Second by Mr. Yule. On the motion, all in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Unanimous? Catherine, take that one?
Okay.
Sure.
Article 6, operating budget, 2017. Mr. Gilberto.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. So we're still working on potential transfers to recommend for the fiscal year 2017 budget. A couple of the areas, and I'll just kind of briefly
switch it.
Thank you very much. Sorry. A couple of the areas that we will note with regard to this that we are looking at, one of which is transfers related to the DPW budget and the salaries that were put into the salary pool during the June budget, potentially transferring out funding for a position or positions, and we'll have a formal recommendation for the October 3rd Selectmen's meeting with regard to that. There were some other areas where adjustments may be required. We have a vacancy that we are looking at filling right now, and while there may not be any immediate financial implication, we are looking at potentially consolidating it with another position, and so we'd review that with the board as well. I'm looking to the finance director. I know that there was a lengthy list that we went through, but the rest of it's not coming to me. If perhaps you could take us through the balance of the things that we're discussing or looking at,
while
still finalizing the details.
There was also an amendment that is needed to the DPW expense budget for a purchase of an attachment to the new track list.
Right.
That is necessary, and I believe we have a quote, but I'm not sure if it's the final quote, so we will have that information for the October 3rd meeting. And we also have some wage classification studies that have been done, so we would need to amend those operating budgets for those department heads and some contractual obligations. Mm-hmm.
Relative to settled bargaining. So we will have a detailed list for the board.
Okay, so the recommendation will be made at town meeting. We have a motion to that effect.
Mr. Chairman, I move to recommend at town meeting Article 6, amend the fiscal year 2017 operating budget.
Second.
Second by Mr. Yule. All in favor?
Aye. Aye.
Opposed? Unanimous? Article 7, rescind
civil
service.
Who's doing that article, Mr. Masseri?
You taking that?
Oh.
Who's taking the article?
Michael?
Well, Kate was up there. She only has one. You want me to go back up?
Yeah.
I have two.
We're
okay,
move
that's fine.
A little bit. Yeah, there's only 13 articles, right?
Okay. So you want me to
just
do
try
it?
That's, no, that's a lot.
Yeah.
All right.
Well, it was either you or Steve should do that one. So.
Okay, that's fine. I got it.
Article 7.
Mike.
Do we have a motion?
Five is Kate.
Mr. Chairman, I move to recommend at town meeting Article 7, rescind civil service for police.
Do we hear a second?
Second.
Second by Mr. O'Leary. Any discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Aye. Oh, I'm sorry, Jeff.
I said aye.
Oh. You raised your hand. Okay, Michael's doing that.
I'm doing that one?
Yep.
Okay. Just so you know, that's four for me now. But
no, it isn't.
Yeah, it is.
Yep.
Yeah, he's doing three, four.
No, it's
no.
Three, four,
no. Oh.
And six and seven now.
Yeah, doing three.
No, it's Jeff is doing one and two. Steve's doing three. You're doing four.
Yeah, we
swapped
three.
Steve,
I gave three to Michael.
Yeah, you Mike. Gave three to Michael.
Yeah,
okay,
yeah, because
I'm
I was
sorry.
Already up there. That's why I was suggesting. Okay. I'll do three, four, and five,
okay.
And then let Kate take six, seven, or whatever.
No,
whatever you want to do.
I don't mind taking seven, Mr. Chairman. That's
okay.
We'll leave it the way you got it.
All right, so Steve's going to do seven.
Yeah.
All right.
That's fine.
Article 8.
I still know what we
did.
I don't mind doing them.
No, I'm trying to balance it out. And
seven.
those articles that are particular to people that are working on subcommittees for. I thought it was only appropriate.
Yeah, no.
Article 8, appropriate money for special counsel legal expenses.
Mr. Chairman, just briefly, this is an article relative to the legal expenses associated with a secondary school building project. We do not have a recommendation at this point in time, but recommend that the article remain on the warrant in the event that we, or for a subsequent recommendation for a particular dollar amount that before town meeting, at town meeting.
I'll entertain a motion to make a recommendation at town meeting.
Mr. Chairman, I move to recommend at town meeting Article 8, appropriate money for special counsel legal expenses.
Second.
Second by Mr. Yule. All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Steve?
No, I think you should do that, Bob. You haven't been able to.
What?
You shouldn't be able to duck all this stuff. You need to do an article or two here.
I'm already doing one, but I'll do it. No problem. I'll do it.
All right. That's good.
Okay. We have appropriate money for construction of the facilities at the J. Kenny Field. Do we have a dollar amount yet?
No.
We don't, through you, Mr. Chairman.
So this will be a recommendation at town meeting.
That would be my suggestion to the board. We are, and I'll just note this for the community and for the board, we are in the process of contracting for designer services with the selected qualified firm. They did conduct a site visit on Thursday or Friday of last week, and we've asked them, and the condition of their proposal was to provide us an approximate budget for the variety of options that were presented to them in time for us to potentially pursue at town meeting. It is an ambitious timeline. I'll be the first to admit that, and but they've committed to work with us to get us through to that phase for purposes of planning for that project.
Mr.
I'll entertain a motion to make a recommendation at town meeting.
Kate has a question for you.
Kate had a question.
Yes, Kate.
No, I was going to make the motion, but I think Jeff has a question.
No, I didn't have a question.
Mr. Chairman, I move to recommend a town meeting Article 9, appropriate money for construction of facilities at Arthur J. Kenny Field.
Second.
Second by Mr. Yule. You had a question, Jeff?
No, actually, Abby has a question.
Yes, Abby.
It's going to be an expensive project.
Yes, Michael.
Through you, Mr. Chairman, and again, I apologize if you guys could not hear my comments earlier. I think an important part of determining the funding strategy is understanding what the cost components are for the variety of options, and that's why we set the aggressive timeline. Whether or not we are able to make a determination as to the funding source will dictate whether or not we actually proceed with a recommendation at town meeting. But I do think we need to understand the magnitude of whatever the options are so that we can plan for them. But the short answer is we've used a working estimate, but we don't know, and we won't know until the study portion of the design is completed. And at that point, we'll have to decide. I think it's a valid concern that we do not have a funding source identified right now, and that, if, as has been stated, if it were to come out of the Capital Improvement Planning Committee's allocation, it would be a significant implication. So those are decisions that we're going to have to make. But I think that we face a significant challenge not knowing what the cost will be, and this study is an important part of that.
So we have a motion to recommend at town meeting. Question has come up regarding the funding source.
To be determined.
TBD. Mm-hmm. Any other questions? Don, the Capital Committee is aware of this, I assume, right?
We're aware that there is a project that came up last year, partway through our process. Was being discussed. That's about as much as I know. Ballpark number that came up last year was $500,000. And as Mike said, if that is funded through the capital improvement plan, that's going to take a pretty big chunk out of anything else we're going to do this year.
Michael.
I thought our waiver was until 2018. Is that not correct?
Through you, Mr. Chairman. So the original approval that we had was that we needed to demonstrate progress by February of 2017, if I remember correctly, at the time it was
16, and so now it's 17.
Yes. So when we spoke with the state, you know, they wanted to see us progressing towards construction with regard to this. If we're in a situation where we have a plan for construction, I do believe that we would be able to appeal to and receive a formal waiver. We've already received an informal indication that they would give us that extension. I think one of the challenges that we face with the funding is the timing of the construction season, and that's been a concern, at least from my standpoint. In order to be able to proceed within a construction season, we would need to have the funding in place at a town meeting prior to the June town meeting. Otherwise, we'll be looking to contract very late with potential contractors in that construction season. Now, that's not to say we couldn't approve it in June of 2016, for example, and June of 2017 and push it to June of 2018. That certainly is an option that's available to us. But I think it's going to be a matter of figuring out how it fits in the capital improvement plan, if it does, or figuring out how it fits within the context of the financial planning team's revenue plan. But the short answer is yes, we have received those indications.
Thank you.
On the motion.
Aye.
Well,
are you asking for a vote?
No, Kate looked at me like she's going to raise a question, so
no,
I stopped.
No.
On the motion, all in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Unanimous. So let's recommend.
Recommend
and
a town meeting.
Steve, you want to do that too?
Yep. Yeah,
recommend a town meeting.
Recommend a town meeting, yep.
Article 10 will be presented by the Community Planning Commission, but we will be making a recommendation at town meeting. I think we have to wait for their recommendation and maybe have them at a meeting prior to town meeting to discuss.
I expect that they'll be
here.
Through you, Mr. Chairman, I expect that they'll be here at the warrant article hearing on October 3rd. I'm sure that would be an opportunity to hear from them. I will just note, because we have not discussed this article too much, that the CPC is seeking funds to create a conceptual plan and implementation study for the redevelopment of underutilized properties on Main Street near its intersection with Route 62. And this is a result of a couple of state and MAPC-funded initiatives that began in late 2014 and occurred through much of the year during 2015. The primary focus of this phase of the work would be an analysis of how the introduction of a privately funded and operated wastewater treatment package plant could be a short or midterm catalyst for the realization of the full development potential for these properties while the town continues to pursue potential long-term solutions, including the Greater Lawrence Sewer District.
So I'll entertain a motion to recommend in town meeting.
Mr. Chairman, through you, we do have an estimate. We've been obtaining quotes from engineering firms, and the range is between $25,000 and $50,000 for this effort.
Okay.
I think that the average has been at about $40,000, but we expect to have that finalized for the October 3rd meeting and a warrant article hearing.
Excuse me, Mr. Chairman.
Yeah.
Were the funds going to be coming from a grant?
For this particular plan, no, not that I'm aware of.
Yes,
that funding source is likely to be free cash. Although, again, as we solidify the number.
We have a discussion with them on this issue.
Yeah. Don has a question.
Yes, Don.
Just a question on where this is located. Is this Route 28 between Winter and Lowell Streets? Is that what we're talking about?
Through you, Mr. Chairman. Yes, that's correct.
And what could we develop in there? It seems like there's lots of stuff in there now.
I think, and again, I don't want to speak for the Planning Commission, but my understanding is that this is the next phase of a land use initiative that was grant-funded over the course of the past year or 18 months to look at the uses that are there and to identify whether there are alternative uses that might be in place for development and what, if anything, a privately funded sewer package plant might be able to allow to occur with those properties, but we are talking about potential redevelopment of existing use properties.
If I could
with the current owners,
I think that the market would likely dictate that, but the initial group that we would be speaking with would be the owners of the properties, absolutely, or that the CPC would be speaking with.
Yes, Michael.
So maybe a quick example will be helpful to understand a little bit better, because I looked into this a little bit, what they're trying to do. And you could just take Heavenly Donut, for example, where it abuts Papagino's, and then you have the facility behind it that's for sale that's vacant right now. One of the owners of that, of those properties could actually work together to build a package plant that could satisfy all those businesses in that area. And together they could, you know, basically build like a homeowners association to help all contribute their funding based on the amount of fluid that they would be contributing to this package plant. And that's how they would get around not having a storage anymore. They have a package plant that they're all sharing the cost in. I think this is definitely a great idea for Route 28, because everybody, I don't think there's anybody in this town will disagree that you don't see us putting storage in anytime soon. But there's no reason why we shouldn't at least allow for the redevelopment to happen. And the technology and the expense of package plants have come a long way now. So what the goal is here is to try to do this study, present it to the business community that owns and the property owners that own the commercial lands to see if there is an opportunity for them to maybe work with their abutters to try to share in these costs, because I think it makes a lot of sense. And I think that's what the ultimate goal is. Did I speak wrong on anything you've heard?
No, that's all consistent with my understanding.
I love the idea. But I think at the October 3rd meeting, we'll learn a lot more.
Any other comments? So on the motion to recommend a town meeting, all in favor?
Aye.
Aye. And that will be presented by the CPC. Article 11, yes. Fund repairs to town buildings. Mr. Gilberto?
Excuse me, just as far as the board's recommendation at town meeting, once we hear the presentation, we take a vote. Someone has to get up and say the board recommends or doesn't recommend.
Well, so we may vote to recommend it that night when we
review
it.
Yeah, so someone needs
right?
to be assigned.
This is what gets published in the.
No,
the
no, but actually, right. Someone needs to be assigned the task of giving the board recommendation. Right. That's all.
So who's going to do the recommendation?
I'll take it.
No, I was going to suggest then that. I was going to give the next article
that's
to
fine.
Catherine. So,
good.
Catherine, do number 10, and you'd just be getting up to say board recommends or not.
What if I want to say more than that?
Well,
yes.
Well, go for it.
Then get Michael to come up instead of you.
Oh, no, no.
Article 11.
She's very capable.
Fund repairs to town buildings.
Mr. Chairman, through you, this is a standard article that we've used for miscellaneous building repairs. We are still in discussion with the building superintendent relative to projects, and to you, the point that was brought up earlier, Selectman Prisco, this is an area we could give an update with regard to the building projects. I know that a lot of headway has been made in the past year with Ms. Knight being on board. There's still a lot more to do. One of the areas that we're looking at is the layout in here in Town Hall to accommodate the new full-time human resource position. That may or may not be part of this recommendation, and we'll have more detail at the October 3rd budget hearing.
So this may be more. The request may be for more?
I do not expect it to exceed $50,000, no. The town meeting and the board and the selectmen, the board selectmen and the finance committee were gracious enough to recommend, and town meeting was willing to approve funding in the amount of $50,000 in the June town meeting, so we certainly would try to live within the means of this $50,000.
So if we make the recommendation for $50,000 tonight and it's less, that's no harm, no foul. Okay, I'll entertain a motion to recommend.
Mr. Chairman, I move to recommend at town meeting Article 11.
Tan, I think it's to recommend, right?
Yes.
Move to recommend.
Fund repairs to town buildings up to the amount of $50,000?
Yes.
Do we need to? Okay.
Up to the amount of $50,000.
Second.
Second, Mr. Yule. All in favor?
Aye.
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 And Kate, will you do that one too?
Sure.
Article 12 is again a CPC article. They'll be presenting it.
Jeff, yeah.
We need a motion to recommend a town meeting.
Mr. Chairman, I move to recommend Article 12, amend the code, the zoning bylaw, section 200-39, changes to highway business zoning district bylaw.
On the motion, all
second.
In favor? Oh, I'm sorry, Steve.
No, he seconded.
I seconded.
Second by Ms. Deal. On the motion, all in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Unanimous. Michael, will you present the board's position?
Sure.
We want to make sure Jeff gets it on the, I know he's gonna kick it off with Article 1.
Yeah, Jeff can take this one. I have 4 now. Kate has 3.
You want Jeff to do this? Okay.
Yeah, Jeff's got 1 and 2, right?
This is just the board position, Jeff, so.
No, I understand that. I know that.
Okay, and then the last article is in a similar vein. I'll entertain a motion to recommend a town meeting. CPC will be presenting it.
Mr. Chairman, I move to recommend Article 13, amend the code, the zoning bylaws, Article 8, Section 200-69. No, Article 13, sorry about that. Section 200-69, changes to off-street parking and loading.
Second. And since I'm standing
there.
Second
by Mr. Yule.
Since I'm standing there, I could.
Any discussion? Hearing none, all in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
And since I'm standing there, I could take that as well.
Jeff, you want to just.
Yeah, since I'm standing.
Put that too.
Finish it off.
Yeah.
Okay. So I think we can go back to the beginning of the meeting. And sign the October town meeting warrant.
So, Mr. Chairman, the motion was made and seconded. We're just waiting on the vote.
Okay, that's correct. All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Unanimous. John, thank you for sitting there. We could have called you a little later, I guess.
Thanks.
Sign this, right?
John, how are you?
He said to get a new copy.
Again?
Still.
Just one page, right?
Do you need a copy of that, Jane?
Usually make a copy on the way out, right?
Yeah.
So I start the meeting and I finish it.
Make sure it's quick.
I will. You guys have to make sure it's quick.
I don't know. Casey, want to help?
Thank you, John. Are we done with this?
Yes.
Okay, next item on our agenda are minutes. Are we now prepared to vote on the executive session on March 28th?
No, we're going to talk about that later.
What? We're going to talk about it in the executive session?
We haven't discussed it. I think we're going to talk about the executive session.
We have to go back into executive session.
Right, so we're going to pass over that. August 22nd, 2016, regular session.
Mr. Chairman, I move to approve the August 22nd, 2016, regular session minutes as written.
Second.
Second by Mr. Yule. Any discussion? Hearing none, all in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Aye. Opposed? Unanimous. Okay, we have to vote to approve the acquisition of 9 Mill Street.
How about public comment first?
Oh, I'm sorry.
We have an audience here.
No. Anyone here for public comment?
Guess not.
Thank you, Steve, for reminding me. Okay. Vote to approve the acquisition of 9 Mill Street.
So there's a new motion for this, right?
Not
the one that's in the original packet?
That's correct. It should be a new motion both in the Dropbox packet, and then there should be a new paper copy as well, Ms. Manupelli. That states that we're voting to sign the purchase and sale and to authorize the chairman to sign to accept the deer.
I have that. Mr. Chairman, I move to approve the purchase and sale for land located at 9 Mill Street, identified as Assessor's Map 21, Parcel 8, of which funding was authorized in Article 18 of the June 2016 town meeting. to acquire 9 Mill Street, to sign the purchase and sale agreement, and to authorize the chairman to sign the deed acceptance, as well as any and all related documentation.
Second.
Second by Mr. Yule. Discussion.
For the town administrator.
Mr. Gilberto.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. This property, number 9 Mill Street, is located just to the north of the town line with the town of Reading, and the purpose of this acquisition would be for the siting of a pump station associated with the MWRA water interconnection project with the town of Reading. Right now, the design calls for water to cross the Ipswich River about the Mill Street Bridge to cross into the town. This is the second parcel north of there. It's a large parcel, more than 4 acres, currently used as a single-family home. And over the past few months, the town has negotiated with the owner to acquire this property. It's been identified as one of the most desirable properties for the location of this pump station. And we would be acquiring this property by virtue of the approval this evening for a cost of $700,000, which is within the June 2016 town meeting appropriation of $750,000. It's an important step in our project with regard to moving forward with the MWRA connection, to have this site secured and to be able to do so in a way without having to go through the process of eminent domain or other takings. This is a friendly acquisition that the town will be undertaking. It's important to note that this will allow us to now proceed further with regard to the design that was funded at the June town meeting with regard to the interconnection. A critical piece of that design is the physical location of the pump station, and with that being now identified, we're able to proceed the next steps in the design. One thing I will note is the construction cost will be a separate cost. It'll be something that will be requested at the June town meeting, as has been planned with regard to the MWRA interconnection project. That construction cost, as I mentioned during the board's meeting last week, we've actually sought a MassWorks state grant to try to offset that construction cost in the amount of $2.55 million. It is a competitive grant program, and we felt more than anything that we need to get ourselves in the queue for state funding, if not this round, then a future round. But this is an important step in the process. I think one thing that we obviously need to note is a number of weeks ago, the town of Andover spoke up with regard to their representations that they had concerning being able to provide the town's water. And speaking on behalf of the board, I think the feeling is that we have a timeline that's associated with this water project that we need to meet, and that's to have water available here from the MWRA on July 1st of 2019, when our intermunicipal agreement with the town of Andover expires. And in order to meet that timeline, we needed to obtain control of this property at this point in time. I'll stop my comments from now. That's kind of the summary. I'm sure other board members have things that they'd like to add with regard to this, and I'd be happy to answer any questions.
Mr. O'Leary.
Just in relation to this specific parcel, as the town administrator pointed out, this is a critical piece and probably the most advantageous one for us to acquire because of its size and proximity, but also in addition to the fact that this particular parcel already has an easement on it, which houses the water line that we're going to be connecting to anyway. So as far as minimizing the impact on the neighborhood, digging up streets and replacing lines, this minimizes that, what could be caused to be more if we had to locate somewhere else. Additionally, the size of the parcel will allow us to situate the pumping station in a less obtrusive manner, pretty much out of sight, off of the roadway, which is, again, an enhancement as far as the parcel itself. And additionally, whether it's of size enough to consider breaking off a parcel and selling off the single family home to recoup some of our costs may be a possibility, but again, we don't know yet. Regardless of the fact, the acquisition price is reasonable and again secures our ability to move forward with this project on this very aggressive timeline that we've set out for ourselves. So I think it's a marvelous opportunity. I think it's wonderful the town meeting already approved this to come to fruition, and I'm happy with the fact that we were able to secure this property at the location that it's at. That's all, Mr. Chairman, thank you. And again, I just wanted to acknowledge local realtor Jerry Farrelly for her assistance in the process, too. She's been invaluable in assisting us in identifying parcels that are available.
I just want to thank you and the town administrator in the efforts of securing this important milestone in terms of bringing the water in from NWRA. It's a key piece of the overall plan, and we've been able to do it without going down the eminent domain route. Well, thank you.
Mr. Keller has a question.
Yes, Don.
Just a question, did we get an appraisal on this property?
We have a market value analysis that was done on the property. And again, this is, again, not an eminent domain taking, so it's a friendly deal. Basically, the market value of the property is approximately $650,000 as it currently sits. But again, for us to secure the property and to ensure that we can do it on a timely basis, there's a little bit of a premium that we're paying for it, but it's certainly within reason. And again, it's the only opportunity we have to get the key parcel which serves our needs best. So it's actually more valuable to us than it's to anybody else.
The reason I ask, if you go on Zillow and look at this property, it's got a Zillow value of about $508,000, and Zillow is low. But this just seemed like a big premium over that price. So I was just curious how we determined the $700,000 value.
We had the assistance of a local realtor. There were several parcels, with three other parcels on Mill Street that were recently sold directly across the street. Mm-hmm. A small cape on, 10,000 square feet, sold for $522,000. Another parcel just three doors up and across the street at 2.3 acres, sold for in excess of $700,000. And the one right next door was on the market, and I believe was sold for, again, $450,000 to $500,000.
Right? Oh, I'm not sure.
Yeah. So, again, it's in the range, and again, with the acreage that's there, the location, the lack of distance that we would have to travel up Mill Street if we buy other parcels, again, where there are savings associated with construction costs that are certainly worth in excess of $100,000.
To the extent that we can resell the property subject to an easement or carving out a piece of this, I think that'd be a good idea. That
if we can, again, we're going to determine because of the configuration of the lot, where the easement is, and what we're going to need, because we're going to need daily access to the treatment plant. We're cognizant of it. There's some wetlands, obviously, because it's near the river, associated with it. But we're certainly going to take a look at it. But that's down the road, and we're not necessarily counting on it. To us, this is a good deal, a fair deal. And again, these people are working with us. They're actually going to be probably staying in the property up to a year and paying the real estate taxes as if it was still in the tax rolls until they relocate themselves. So,
Mr. Chairman.
Mr. Prisco.
There was a lot of discussion on the board about the price, but I think when you step back and you look at the risk assessment associated with this transaction, I think it's definitely justifiable why we pulled the trigger on this at the value we pulled it at.
My only question wasn't where we bought it or we should buy it. I think we should. It was just, were we paying fair value for the property?
No, but for the folks sitting at home, I just want to make sure it's clear to them that this, we didn't just decide to do this because we love the people in the house. It was the right price based on the situation, and from a risk standpoint, it eliminated a significant portion of risk that we had in this whole program when we went to October town meeting. Coming out of June town meeting, this was our number one risk factor, and now that's been completed once we signed this purchase and sale.
And additionally, the appropriation at the June town meeting did not allow for any eminent domain taking. It was our goal in June, to come to some sort of an agreement with whatever property owners we were going to be talking to some sort of a friendly agreement as opposed to eminent domain taking. As you're aware, Mr. Keller, the town's record and most any community's record in eminent domain taking has not been very good. And we generally end up paying far more than fair market value once it goes before a court. The goal, and again, the article was specifically worded to allow us to go and negotiate and purchase, which is what we've been able to do. And again, as Mr. Prisco said, from a risk standpoint, we've minimized the risk, we've got the ideal location, we're going to minimize costs as far as construction and connection. The value of that to us is significant.
There's a timing factor, too.
And there's a timing factor as far as, having it available.
Any other questions? On the motion, Mrs. Menapelli.
Sure, I think you already read it.
You
read the motion, right.
Did we do a roll call?
Got a second from Mr. Yule. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Unanimous. Thank you. Town Administrator's Report. Mr. Gilberto?
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. First thing that I noted to the board was that I was pleased to report that the Finance Director, Building Superintendent, and the IT Technician have been working on a scope of modest improvements for Room 14 and Room 5 here in Town Hall. This is a follow-up to a discussion that began in the summer of 2014, if I remember correctly. Mm-hmm. And we're looking at a budget for some improvements in this room alone, somewhere around $75,000. And I had committed to the board that we would try to find an ability to make some modest improvements that wasn't quite as aggressive as that plan. So what we have here is a number of different improvements that we're looking to make in this room, the first of which is the installation of two new 60-inch monitor displays, as well as a drop-down screen and projector, and an accompanying podium here in room 14, along with a 60-inch display for room 5. In room 14, the screens that we would put in would feed directly to the NORCAM broadcast, which would avoid the circumstance of the camera having to try to pan in on the screen. The second thing is that we're looking at new modular tables that could be configured into a horseshoe here in room 14. For a meeting, and similarly new tables in room 5, which would replace tables that had some peeling laminate. The room 14 tables would also have some new skirting, which would indicate the town seal on the front of it as well for a board meeting setting. We'll also be looking at acquiring new chairs for room 5 to replace the chairs that have been in there, removing the bulletin boards here in room 14, as well as a fresh coat of paint here in room 14, and that would be done, we expect, using in-house staff, although it will depend upon the timing of filling a position that's been vacant and we're interviewing for, as well as relocating the remaining books here in room 14 to another location, potentially in the library, but also potentially here in the town hall. And then finally, we've been working with NORCAM relative to, hold your breath, relocating the speakers that are up here in the ceiling. There are, you can see them, they're kind of off color. There's four speakers that are in there. The two that are to the front would actually be moved further to the back, which should reduce the feedback that NORCAM sees when it broadcasts and allow us to turn the volume up a little bit here in this room. Thank NORCAM for their assistance with regard to that. So the estimated cost of this work is approximately $14,000 for the technology, $3,000 for the electrical work, and $12,000 for the furniture to address the needs in both rooms. Please note that this, again, is far less than a $75,000 estimate for improvements to room 14 only. The project is proposed to be funded by unencumbered, unexpended funds from previous fiscal years, to which the finance director can speak more directly if there's any questions.
Jeffrey.
Yeah, with item F, relocation of the front row, the speakers and so on, how does that work with our relationship with NORCAM? They're charging us to do this work, and so we are paying them, or how is that?
I do not have an expectation that we would be paying to do this. I mean, NORCAM, I think, has generally used in-house resources to move things around at no cost to the town. I mean, they're here, and they don't charge us a cost to set up for the meetings when they come in. We call them to set up for special events. So I don't foresee that there'll be an additional cost. Again, there may be materials costs that are related to it, but I don't expect it to be significant.
Is so that's not part of this $14,000?
That's correct.
Dollars? Okay. So, okay. Thank you.
Any other questions?
Just want to thank Michael. You for bringing this forward. It's been a long time coming. We've discussed it way even before your time, so it'll be nice to see us have a very professional atmosphere to work in. I'm looking forward to it. Thank you.
I appreciate the board's comments, but I just would note Liz, who put a lot of time and effort into this, Julie Spurr-Knight, who put a lot of time into kind of valuing what the right investment was and trying to keep things under control in terms of the cost. Ryan Carter from IT, and I need to definitely note the involvement of Eugene Torek, who on the front end of this put a lot of time into designing the system to fit this room properly.
So the only question I have left is, there's nothing you can do about the heat in here, though.
I would let the record know show that we did have one season with a thermostat actually worked properly.
We did.
But it was only
we actually
season.
Did.
I know that.
I'm just kidding.
In all seriousness, though, I would note that the building superintendent is concerned with regard to the functionality of the pneumatic controls in this building, it's something where we may need to make some adjustments to it. But the short answer is right now, no, I don't have that answer.
That's okay. I didn't expect that answer. Thank you.
Anything else, Michael?
Yes. So I did include a copy for the board of the letter that our consultants sent over to Andover. It's a follow-up to the representations that they made to us in the early part of August relative to water. It asked some pretty detailed questions with regard to what their proposal might be, and I can tell you that I have spoken with the town manager. He's committed to providing a response in a timely fashion, as we all know, we are under some very tight timelines associated with this water project. The third thing I would note, and I neglected to mention it at the last meeting when I mentioned the MassWorks application, we did sign a letter of support for a regional application that the town of Middleton put in to improve transportation along Route 62. It was not competitive, not competing with the funding for our infrastructure project for the construction of the pump station. They're separate funds. One's an economic development. I should say they're separate categories. One's an economic development project and one is a transportation project. So I felt comfortable that in exchange for the support Middleton was providing us, which gives us much needed points in the scoring system, that it was a reasonable accommodation, particularly given that that school that's a technical school, which is located on Route 62 where the improvements are scheduled to be made, does serve individuals from North Reading, as well as a number of people who commute through that area as well. I just would note for the board, I do plan to attend the October 14th MMA legislative breakfast meeting in Amesbury for any board member that's interested in joining me. We did attach a copy of the town's 2016 MMA Chapter 90 survey. I thank Mike Sorgan, the acting director, Bob Moylan, and Jacqueline Stelty for their efforts on that. And then finally, and it relates to the town meeting warrant, there was a request very early on in the planning for the October town meeting relative to whether any bylaw change would be required to allow for the consumption of alcohol on town-owned property. And the standing interpretation of the town's bylaws had been that there was a provision that effectively grandfathered licensed properties for consumption, but that no new location could be established. I did follow up with town council and the feedback that I received from them, as I had given some preliminary indication to it the first meeting this was brought up, was that the bylaw as written effectively does permit for the board to be able to issue such a license here within the town's borders, subject to certain conditions and certainly incorporating the feedback from any of the involved departments as we do for any licensing process. And so for that reason, I believe that the need that was affected and brought up was addressed, and there isn't a warrant article that was proposed for it. I do expect that we'll probably receive requests. One thing that I would just note is when we're talking about the town hosting an event, there is a responsibility and obligation that we have to obtain insurance coverage, and that does bring a cost with it. So I expect that, you know, that any utilization of this would be certainly subject to the board's approval for licensing, but also mm-hmm. limited because of the cost associated with it. But there may be vendors who wish to pursue this and to cover the cost on their own, such as the individual from the farmers market who brought this up to us first in 2015, I believe. And that concludes my comments.
Did the BOS correspondence, is that something you were going to talk about in your administrative update? Or was that in there for a reason?
No, so we've started putting the correspondence into the particular meeting folder to ensure that they show up for the board each meeting.
Thank you.
Okay.
Thank you, Lou.
Just in relation to the last item, Mr. Chairman, I think myself included, we're under the misimpression that we couldn't allow, you know, like a tasting, you know, at the farmer's market and places like that. And mm-hmm. I think it's good that we are now aware that we would be able to, and we'll just have to look at if there's any additional costs associated with that and if the vendor would be willing to pick up the cost in order to perfect it. Because I think it's important, you know. It's nice to have the farmer's market and have, you know, a local vintner or area vintner there to try and sell his wares, but if he can't give you a taste of it to see if you like it, not much sales go on. So I just think it's I think it's a good idea, and I think we should encourage people like that to come forward. And again, if there's a special event that someone wants to utilize a town facility, you know, I think we should have the flexibility to say yes on some, you know, occasions to do so. So I think that's good. And I'm glad we didn't need a warrant article to change it.
Okay. Well, old and new business, why don't you start off, Steve, since...
Sure. I didn't know, Mr. Chairman, if you were going to mention the Veterans Dinner?
I was.
Okay, then you can do that. The only thing I'll bring up then is the Hillview Commissioners Golf Tournament, Sunday, October 2nd, the annual Commissioners Cup.
Holy cow, that's coming right at us.
That's coming up Sunday, October 2nd, and again, you can call Parks and Recreation, and it's $125 per golfer, or a team of four for $500, and it's always a good time, and it's probably not going to rain, so it's probably going to be a good day. And again, so I would encourage people to participate. Other than that, Mr. Chairman, I'm all set.
Thanks for reminding me, because I was supposed to go over and sign up, and I didn't. Jeff.
Yes. Two things. Last weekend, last Saturday, they had the Apple Fest, and it was a success as it usually is. We had beautiful weather. A lot of things for kids to see and to participate and to watch, and things to buy. So, and they do this every year. It's a credit to the Historical Society, which I believe that does that. And it's just a wonderful, wonderful day. And it will happen again next year, and hopefully people will go again next year. On a another note, on a more somber note, at least for me anyway, this past weekend, the neighborhood where I grew up, the very street where I was born, where I scratched my knees, took my lumps, and experienced the most wonderful childhood, was attacked by Islamic jihadist terrorists. I have since moved away from Chelsea, New York, but my heart still remains with those from my childhood who may still be living there, and those who are experiencing the neighborhood as I did as a little boy going through his formative years. Chelsea is similar to North Reading, where a community of families carefully watched over their young, just as we do, through neighborhood programs and a watchful eye. Unfortunately, that is not enough. Too many have died, from Texas to California, down to Florida, up to New York, and other places too many to mention, but not to be forgotten. It is long overdue for our political leaders, the President and Congress, to fulfill their number one responsibility of protecting the people of the United States. For this, there should be no discussion. Thank you.
Anything else? Catherine?
Nothing to add to that, other than to say I'm happy that they grabbed the suspect that they were looking for and detained some people that they think are responsible for it, and hope that they quickly bring these people to justice.
Nothing else?
That's all.
Michael?
Yes, I actually just have one thing, and it's sort of bringing up something I brought up right after June town meeting, and is, you know, how do we accommodate our seniors in this town that want to attend town meeting? And with the limited ability to enter into the new high school performance arts center, you know, I had suggested that maybe we consider hiring a limousine service, or try to find a way we can rope off parking right up in the front of that building, where they literally have less than a 30-yard walk to get into the performance arts center or to the elevator. I would like us to just take a few minutes tonight to see if there is any option we can do to try to improve the abilities for the seniors to attend.
Mr. O'Leary.
The superintendent of schools has already taken action and is going to be notifying the transcript that you know, there's going to be segregated parking outside the principal's office, which is very close to the Performing Arts Center, for handicapped parking. They're looking to work with the student council and other student organizations to assist people who need some assistance, whether it be moving the cars or helping them into the building, to be available at town meeting. And they're very much aware and cognizant of the situation, and going to be making efforts to advertise the availability for assistance and the close proximity of parking for people to attend town meeting. So I want to thank the superintendent, John Bernard, for working towards achieving the goals that you're actually pointing out, Mike, and hopefully it goes a long way to ease people's concerns in relation to their desire to attend town meeting and the long walk down Main Street to get there. So it is being addressed. The superintendent is looking to advertise that before town meeting and make the public aware, and also make the town clerk's office aware as to what accommodations are going to be made.
Mr. Goldberg.
Go ahead, Michael.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. In addition to that, I know one of the issues that came up was the ability to access the elevator and it being locked and being able to get in and out, and that's something that we've worked with the superintendent of schools and the building facilities manager over there to try to come up with a contingency plan to make that area more accessible, and I think that they've got that addressed as well. And I just would like to also note the town clerk who did a walkthrough of the facility after the last town meeting to try to come up with some options, if I remember correctly, and has been in touch with the superintendent of schools. So between the two of them, they've come up with a great plan to try to improve access to the best that we can.
Great. I look forward to hopefully it'll work, and we'll see some much-needed improvement. I'm sure the community will appreciate it. That's all I have. Thank you.
Thank you, Michael. So I just want to remind everybody and those watching that the Veterans Dinner is this Sunday at the Hillview, 2 p.m. I think it goes to 4:30, as I recall.
That's 2 to 6.
And the price is $35 per person.
Why don't you pass that down to Bob?
There's the flyer. I'm gonna read the whole thing.
That's the flyer, sir.
What?
Take whatever information you want. That's the flyer.
Okay, so it's open to the public. There'll be light appetizers and a plated meal and dessert. A day of honoring our veterans, special honors to Vietnam veterans, commemorating the 50th anniversary of the Vietnam War. And again, as I said, tickets are $35 per person. And that's at the Hillview. At 2 p.m., it's going to run to 6 p.m. I stand
and contact correct. The Veterans Agent's office if you're interested.
Yes, you're in Town Hall. Wanted to remind the board that
Mr. Chairman?
Well, yes.
May I comment on the Veterans Dinner, just to give an emphasis?
I'm sorry?
May I comment on the Veterans Dinner?
Yes, yeah, sure.
Yeah, I just want to acknowledge that there was a lot of work that was put into this to get this going, and Susan Magna and the committees have worked really hard. Yes, you're right. It's a special, it's a really special day. Unfortunately, I'm going to be out of town for the weekend, and I cannot attend, and I'm a little disappointed in that because I was looking forward to it. But for anybody who hears this or is listening, this is really a special event where the veterans are truly, truly recognized for the time that they put in and for the time that has gone by. So I just wanted to share that. Thank you.
You all set, Jeff?
Thank yes.
You. I wanted to remind the board that we have our next board meeting is October 3rd. And that's when we're going to go through and have the public hearing on the articles. We have scheduled our strategic planning meeting for the 6th. That's the Thursday following the Monday meeting. And it'll be at 6:30 at the police station.
We'll need to confirm the location, unless Jane...
Is that squared away, or...?
We'll confirm the location for the board at the before the October 3rd meeting,
so
and we'll state it publicly.
We haven't got that nailed down yet. And we'll supply dinner or something to eat. And then, of course, we have town meeting on the 17th, so we have no plans for a meeting between an official board meeting between the 3rd and the 17th, with the exception of the strategic plan. And that's all I have. I will entertain a motion to adjourn our regular session and proceed after a short break into our to continue our executive session.
So moved.
Mrs. Manapelli.
Second.
Second? Okay. So, on the motion to adjourn our regular meeting, say aye.
Aye.
But to go to executive session, we need a roll call.
Yeah, I think we need a roll call.
I know. So, Mr. O'Leary.
Aye.
Mr. Yule.
Aye.
Mrs. Manapelli.
Aye.
Mr. Prisco.
Aye.
Chair votes aye. We'll take a 5-minute break to allow NORCAM to shut down.